That's logical. I know. Yeah. The brain knows he's saying, and the other thing is going, yeah.
But the text came out much clearer. There was more, I would love to see more discovery at the beginning, like greeting, a little more joy of making this book, or, you know, I don't know where it's coming from, but something a little more discovery.
More discovery, yeah.
But I like the discoveries that were matched with the actions. Like, what was this? Ah, here we are.
Yeah.
And those are places where sound can come out, mm-hmm. I think.
I felt like it was all more exciting the second time around.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a nice place. I really like.
I like the. If you didn't do the first part of the poem, did you do that the first time you did it?
Yeah.
Repeat it. The refrain. The repeating of the first couple of lines at the end.
Yeah.
You did that the first time.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, I was kind of like playing it all flat.
Yeah, it was my. I was really, you know, becoming a tiger. And I loved, sorry, I know I'm going on, but the repeated gesture of you as the sculpture, as the creator, as the artist here, whoo, and then you as the tiger with the cleaning. That was
yeah, that was a lovely little moment. I was like, ooh, that felt so right. And you have to stay in character at the same time. Huh?
Yeah, we get really pleased with ourselves.
Yes, I like that. The first time you did it, I immediately thought like you were like, being like a cat, like cleaning yourself.
Mm-hmm.
But then I was like, thinking about like this, and I was like, no, she's still a sculptor at this point. Mm-hmm. And then you went back and did it again, and I was like, that was good.
Foreshadowing.
Yes.
Foreshadowing.
Cool.
What else?
I was going to say that this time, you know, we talked in terms of clarity. The last time it was more clear because I felt that when you were like speaking the words and like, investing the words that you were really doing that, and then almost that informed your physical movement, and then when you physically moved, that perhaps informed what the next line was going to be. So it was a little bit more of like overall kinesthetically and verbally listening, which was I thought was cool. So
paying attention to myself.
Yeah, or allowing what you were doing every move to lead into the next. Almost the point is very similar.
The text was impelled.
Yeah.
It came from a place that wasn't just I'm reciting this poem and trying to match the poem to the action. No, the action informs my text, and that's what so many people forget.
And
neglect to do with their acting is to have the text actually come from something.
My teacher used to say you can't improve text like this. You have to live up to it.
And allow it to work.
Yeah.
Work you.
And bring you up to that level. Bring yourself up to that level and be brave.
I think you can still enjoy the language much more.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Enjoy.
What else? Anybody else have some things? Comments, notices, observations?
Cool.
Gru is an animator. How'd you do as a tiger?
I like the move of the tiger. I was actually drawing the footwork, so.
Yeah.
You paid a lot more attention to where your feet were the second time than the first time.
Yeah, the tiger grew a lot.
There's much more specificity.
Well, I came to the end of the human.
Mm-hmm.
I gave the punctuation really could set the clear mark for me between one character and the next one. Mm-hmm. They had great distinction there. I could feel.
There's a very good precision of movement.
It's cool. Thank you.
All right, somebody else get up.